I can't believe I broke a promise I made myself. I thought I would never watch that video.
Sorry, this is an update video. I'm supposed to tell my viewers what I've been up to. Hello, my fellow viewers and subscribers. It has been about 5 months ever since my last video about my history on Welsh dubs. And I'm glad to see that it's reached about over 1,000 views. But still know anything about those dubs I've talked about being found. But anyway, what have I been doing for the past 5 months, you may ask? Well, let me tell you, because this time I'm only going to be showing you images instead of clips this time around. So, first off, right after uploading my video of me explaining about Welsh dubs, I took a break on making YouTube videos for a while, as I hadn't thought of any ideas for the next videos I would be making. But I promised you that I would be still active on my channel. Which I wasn't until now. So one thing I didn't tell you is that I discovered a website called Filmot, a search engine where you type up words and phrases as well as YouTube channels. I was just snooping around looking up things from stuff like Thomas, Sonic, Mario, My Little Pony, Pokemon, which I'll get into these two later in the video, SpongeBob, Mr. Men, and etc. Besides those things I like, as well as those shows from my childhood, there was one show that I hadn't thought about as I kept on looking around the website, and that was this show. Yup, bet you weren't expecting to guess that. So, if you can't tell already, while I did grow up watching LazyTown when it was on CBeebies, I somehow became a massive fan of it when that one song you all know became a meme sensation and rewatched every episode of it. Well, only the British dub, as that's the version I grew up with, so sorry. Anyways, I fell in love with the show mostly because of the songs and particularly the humour, mostly coming from the show's main antagonist, Robbie Rotten. And if you may not know what I'm getting at, you can already see that there are videos that have LazyTown in them when I was making videos on Movie Maker back in 2017 and 18, when I was still into it. And that is evident when I first uploaded my videos I made onto my channel. So, back to Filmot. I searched up the names of the characters, quotes, and terminology the show LazyTown gave out. I became so interested in getting back into it that I listened to every song of the show, and that from that day in June, I binge-watched the show every day. But only watching 5 episodes per day, as I did its difference like I did back in 2016 and 17, where I only watched 1 episode. But aside from that, my fanboy instincts faded a little when that We Are Number One song started to become less relevant, and the LazyTown fandom just stopped making videos around 2018 and 19 or so. But I still listened to some songs here and there, so that's something. Right after that, during the summer holidays, I went to Perros-Guirec in France, with only my parents. And I was thinking of watching something that I did complete from a series that I was into and probably still into. I'm talking about the Equestria Girls film series from My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. So, fun fact, I actually did watch the first installment all the way back in 2013, just when it was first uploaded on Watch Anime Dub. This was the very first time I've watched something related to that series, as I was very shy of watching it, despite me making some fan art of it, like with Sonic and Pokemon. And funnily enough, 5 years later, I did the same with My Little Pony the movie to commemorate me watching that movie I saw years ago or something. And as you already know, I didn't watch the series proper until in January of 2019, where I became an actual brony. But I didn't even collect any merchandise or anything, so what was the point? I stopped watching it right after the very last episode, and I couldn't give it another chance since I thought... Well, Rainbow Dash was kind of unlikable. Ish. So, I stopped caring and went on back to Pokemon, where I became a fan of Lucario. And his relationship of his son Riolu that sadly was never established in the franchise. But come July of 2020, where I got back into it, only this time I started to ship Twidash. Because that was a couple I was into but later forgotten about and was replaced with Rainbow Dash and Scootaloo's relationship, and that I never saw a single episode, mostly because of those last two seasons where I just didn't like how Rainbow Dash was treated. Or maybe I was being too harsh on her, as justified. She can be brash at times. Whatever. So yeah, I watched all four Equestria Girls movies, and I have to say, they're fine enough. Although I'd say that Rainbow Rocks was one of my favorites. Because reasons. Now, I don't know whether I'd rewatch it or not, since I really wanted to show it to my sister and she may learn a few things from it, like with the characters and such, but only time will tell. And also, there was my birthday that happened, and I'm giving you a guess which game I had for the Nintendo Switch, so here we go.
Is it Sonic Origins?
Nope. Although I may have had the chance to play the classic since I didn't get past them, with the exception of CD.
Is it Sonic Colors Ultimate?
Nope, not that either, since it's a broken port.
Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury.
It was actually, believe it or not, Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Rescue Team DX. Yeah, that's right. You weren't expecting me to hear that I actually have the very first Pokemon game on a Nintendo console, as that other time, it was a mobile phone craze as I downloaded it on my iPad, but was then deleted since. But also a fun fact, I actually first played the demo 2.5 years ago, when my family and I went to London. One time, me and my dad visited a mall and went in the electronics area. There, among other things related to technology, was a gaming section. One of them was a Nintendo Switch, and to my surprise, has a demo of that Mystery Dungeon remake that I've heard of, but never cared about that much. I played it for about 6 minutes or so, until my dad called me and stopped. Not to mention this, but originally, along with New Super Mario Bros. U, I was going to have this game for my birthday, since I was sort of a semi-fan at that time. But since that fear kept contaminating me with things like characters raising their voices and whenever they're shouting, or very intense and dark scenes that make me uncomfortable like whatever I'm listing here, I started to lose interest and just not go back into it unless my fear goes away. But the reason I had this for my birthday was because... well, I think it's because I was looking at things related to Pokemon on websites like TV Tropes, Bulbapedia, the Pokemon Wiki, and Filmot and whatnot. But that doesn't mean I'm gonna watch an episode of the anime anytime soon, as it's still inside of me. But anyway, for this game, I've chosen Eevee as the main character, because Eevee is obviously cute and probably my 11th favorite Pokemon or whatever, and that I chose Pikachu as my partner. Because, you know, Pikachu and Eevee have both been the two main faces of the Pokemon franchise as they keep on showing up together in stuff since 2018. Now then, I'm about 60% finished with the game, as there are big dungeons that I haven't even completed, as they're so hard. Okay, so despite me playing the first Pokemon game since that one on mobile devices, it's very tricky of me to say that I might be a fan again, as I just don't want to watch an entire episode of the anime again, so unless if anything will scare me again or not. So yeah, that's the stuff I've been doing for the past few months, and I have to say, I wish I could have seen better. What do I mean by that? It's best not to tell you. But what's the next video, you may ask? Well, remember those series of videos where I show you VHS tapes and DVDs of shows that I've watched as a kid, with clips representing what's in them? You'd be curious to know when I'm announcing that I'm going to be reviewing some of those things that I watched in home media. Basically in the same style as Gondorf's video memories, if you will. So, much like Sketches from the Past and my Welsh Kids Shows reviews, I'm going to be talking about some VHSs and DVDs that I owned as a kid and see how they still hold up. So, be on the lookout for that, as I will do just that. As always, this is NinHitsFan2000 signing out, and I regret watching that video I'm not supposed to watch, or else it'll traumatize me forever.